Just had more experience this year, more seniors. How much of a difference can that make on the floor?
I think leadership, and I think we're getting a great leadership from Andrea Carter and Jordan Reynolds, and then with Ariel back, it's been awesome. It really has been super. They've stepped up. I think probably Andrea more than the other two, but she's taking it on. It's her responsibility, and she's doing a heck of a job. Just a great job in being a great leader.
So you mentioned the competition at that position then? I mean, is it Ariel's job again?
I don't think anybody's job is secure or set or etched in stone. We got a lot of people that can play different roles, and I think with the recruiting of our three freshmen and people who are coming back that are solid, eventually when Jana gets back, I just think that we've got a lot of options, and that's what we wanted. We wanted to make sure we can get kids that can play multiple positions, and I think that's what you're going to see.
What is Jana's status on?
It's day-to-day. I think she's is no contact right now. She can go up and down. But I think probably November, that's me. I haven't talked to the doctors, but I think around November that she could be projected in playing some.
That's still the knee, or is that something different?
Yeah, no, it's just we're just very cautious about her knee.
How's everybody else physically going into?
You know, I think they're good. I think we're solid. We're just healing some bumps and bruises. I think Mercedes is progressing. I think Diamond is progressing. So I think for the most part, Coach Taylor's done a great job of getting them in shape and getting them ready and keeping them healthy.
First day of practice, what do you have planned for them? Is it more competitive drills or?
A lot of defensive work, because I think that's what we want to do. And it's always going to be a little bit of competitive. We always do rebounding drills. That's kind of our staple. We've got to get better defensively, and then we're going to do some transition offense, those three. But probably you will see probably 80% of our practice today will be on the defensive end.
What are the biggest questions kind of about this team that you kind of want to see answered in the next few weeks? What are you most interested in seeing?
Well, I just how we play together. We obviously got more opportunities to play people. How we're going to respond. What groups are going to play well together? As far as a certain five, if I had to name a starting five right now, I wouldn't know where to really begin, but. I think that's a good problem to have, because I think we have people that can step in and do a lot of things. We have talent, and I think we have a lot of things to choose from depending on who we play and what we want to do in that game.
How's Ariel look?
She looks good. Ariel looks good. I think just her thing is just getting back in shape because she's been out. But I think that hers is just getting up and down, getting in basketball shape. I mean, I think she's good going up and down, but just the stops and the starts and going from offense to defense and that quick transition and turnaround that she's just got to get used to.
You're talking to Sierra, and she's kind of thinking she might play more four with Mercedes out. I mean, how do you see her role?
Yeah, I mean, you saw at the end of the year, I thought Sierra played a little bit more of the four as well. But we're going to do a little bit of different offensively. We're going to spread the floor a little bit more play some people at the four, which normally the four for everybody else is not a get on the block and post up type of a four player for us. So we're going to spread the four out. We can go with four guards and a post, or we can actually go with five perimeter players. So we're going to do a lot of experimenting.
What Ariel was saying, this being the third year of this staff, that the players are kind of heeding the words of the staff a little bit more. Do you sense there's more buy-in now than maybe in the past? Or?
I think so. I think that when you change a coaching staff and it is going to be an adjustment, especially for the seniors, because Pat was involved here and then they've had to see me go from an assistant coach to a head coach. And I think it's a different role I have to play, and with them as well. So I think that transition, I think at first was a little challenging, but I think now they're comfortable. They understand what we want to do, and those three, they have to be our leaders as well. If they're not vocal, they got to be leaders by example, and I think definitely Isabella has been a huge leader for us, and she looks she's just playing, I think, with so much confidence. And so if I had to say, you know what, there's one person, one player that I think that would I could say would start right now would be Izzy. She just has had a great summer, and she's really taken this team, wrapped her arms around them, and tried to make them feel included and giving that team atmosphere.
Holly, do you feel like you need more production out of those other two seniors, Sierra?
Well, Dan, I think those two seniors have done a great job in their productivity. Could maybe be a little bit more consistent, but you watch the end of the season, and Sierra stepped up big before Ariel got hurt. She was putting up big numbers, actually leading our team in scoring. So, you know, I think they're gonna come back where they left off. They're too competitive. They practice too hard. They put in the time. They put in the energy, and I just see them coming back and taking over where they left off.
Where do you see these freshmen? Where do you see them at right now coming in?
Well, I think they're still learning. They're obviously learning on the defensive end. They've hung really tough with our conditioning program, weight and running. So I feel really good about where they are. Theirs is just getting time and reps and understanding our philosophy and what we want. But I think they will play. I think they'll play a lot, and I think they'll play early.
With Megan gone, how do you replace that perimeter scoring? Do you see some of this stepping up in that room?
Well, I think we score by committee. I think we're very offensive minded. I think we got some people that can put the ball in the basket. And as Megan, we lose that punch, we're going to probably spread it out and not have one person probably score as many points. I'm not going to tell them they can't score, but I think the ball's going to be spread around a little bit more and give others some more people some opportunities to put points on the board.
Do you feel good about your three-point shooting, given what you're seeing out there?
You know, yes, probably not right now as consistent as Meg could when she was on a roll, but I do. I feel pretty strong about it. I think that we have that capability. We got a little bit more mid-range shooters, which I like, because not too many, they're either three-point shooters or go all the way to the basket. So I think we've got some good mid-range shooters right now. But I think we do have the players and the ability to stretch the defense and shoot the three.
And what sold Diamond to Shields this offseason on the Tennessee program? She was freshman player of the year at North Carolina last year.
I just think Diamond just in her mind needed a change environment, change. I think she went to North Carolina for certain reasons, and you know, I've known Diamond since she's been a little kid, and we recruited her a very long time because her mother played here, and you know, and I think sometimes you get interested or things happen that interest you to that school, and I think that's what she did. I don't think she has any ill feelings towards North Carolina. I just think she needed a change, and she thought Tennessee could do that for her.